globally and around the world, waste has been identified as one of the big climate issues, especially with the release of greenhouse gases and methane, to be more specific.
Methane is the worst gas in terms of climate change. Dealing with methane and having multiple solutions to reduce methane emissions into the atmosphere is a very important part of climate change mitigation.
We need to radically shift our whole paradigm, and zero waste is the most viable solution we have. We're looking for a patchwork of local solutions. This is one of them.
If you want zero waste solutions, you have to have the data.
We did a really detailed, granular audit of the waste coming out of that early morning market.
We liaised with waste pickers because we wanted to now go deep into the bin.
Nontlantla from South African Waste Pickers Association, she's the expert, so she helped us identify what waste is valuable. When we calculated it, 400 tons of waste per year coming out of that market was organic. What happens to that organic waste is it goes to landfill, it gets in with the mixed waste. That's not conducive to making anything except methane gas.
We've got this figure, we've got this waste. It shouldn't be going to landfill.
There's transport costs, fuel costs, emissions from those trucks. There's a lot of pressure on the city to do something different.
We know that if we take waste that is organic and we process it correctly, you get beautiful, rich nutrients for your soil.
And composting at a garden or at a park is a no-brainer. Why wouldn't you want compost made where compost is used? So we're here at the Durban Botanic Gardens. Here we make compost every Tuesday. We collect waste from the early morning market in Warwick, and we also get garden waste from the Durban Botanic Garden. Our recipe is carbon and nitrogen rich dried brown leaves with green garden waste. If you look in the bin, you'll see waste from the early morning market, and it's largely mixed fruit and vegetable waste, things like tomatoes, cabbage leaves, lettuce, and this is the nitrogen that's used for our organic compost. If we weren't making this compost, all of this waste would be going to our landfill sites.
Here's our friends. That's the friendly critters that you want to see in the compost tip. We had to think about composting being cutting edge, but it really is. It's a science. It's the beginning of everything.
Having DET Horticulture on board is very valuable to us. They understand the science behind it.
Yeah, it's everything is being timed, we're measuring it, volumes, kgs, temperature, pH. We would like to test the compost once it's made. We're going to grow plants in it. We're going to look at the biomass of the plants. Our hypothesis is that this compost that we are producing, when tested against the other commercial varieties, is going to be producing plants of a higher biomass, better plants. We know it's possible. So why shouldn't it be done? If you're taking the waste to the landfill, just bring it here and we'll compost it.
It doesn't matter who you ask, any scientific expert, the United Nations, even cities, climate office, organic waste should not be going to landfill. But now we need to start doing that. Who better to look after the operations than two units in the city who are right there close to each other and can make this happen?
I think the location is key. If you think that the early morning market is less than a 2 kilometre round trip to pick up that waste, the opportunity of collaborating is rich. And a resource that would have been regarded as simply a waste product is now being transformed into a really beneficial product for improving parks and public green space.
When this kind of project takes place, to me, it's like my baby. It's minimizing the number of bins that are being emptied, which is a cost to the city.
When the team came here, I was really surprised to see what they're going to do with the bins and the waste. Before that, it was just waste to me. At the moment, we pay quite a lot of money for DSW. So if this organic waste can be used for recycling, we'll obviously be saving money, which can be used in this market for the other projects that we need.
Whatever savings that you will make, let it be re-injected back to the market so that the traders themselves are encouraged to push this project forward.
So it's a very tiny trial that's happening now, where we're just taking one 240 litre bin from the early morning market a week. But now, yes, because there's momentum, there's buy-in and there's excitement around it, we're seeing this beautiful, rich compost that's being produced. Definitely the partners are ready to scale up.
Instead of getting one container, we're going to get a bucky load or a truck load.
The potential we can see with this project is that all 400 tons of organic waste that is currently leaving that market and doing an over 60k round trip to dump in the landfill site stays within a 2k radius to become composted and used as rich nutrients for botanic gardens and possibly for a food garden network throughout the city.
We want to get to the point where we're throwing nothing away, we're not throwing any scrap of garden waste away. We're seeing all that organic food waste being reutilised as well. We're making our own compost, and the whole value cycle through a sort of closed economy loop is being achieved.
Well, what excuses do we have? Let's start with this project.
Working together, we can actually make change. Although we're sweating, but we're sweating for the right reasons. Making sure organic waste is diverted away from landfill.